Well, the search is on for 36-year-old Christopher Vecchiarelli. He's suspected of attacking and strangling a woman just weeks after he was released from jail early because of the coronavirus. Dylan Thomas broke the details of this story earlier today.
This is just another example of what could happen when we release inmates early before they've really served their sentences.
36-year-old Christopher Vecchiarelli is now at the center of an assault and strangulation case. Court documents obtained by CBS4 show he had been released from jail early amid COVID-19 concerns.
Christopher is on the run from law enforcement.
Vecchiarelli was jailed in February for a DUI and child abuse conviction, sentenced to 2 years with a mandatory 60-day stay. In a statement to a judge supporting a lawsuit by the ACLU, he accused Sheriff Steve Reams of doing absolutely nothing to protect inmates from the spread of the coronavirus. His defense told Judge Michelle Lynn Meyer she had, quote, a moral responsibility and duty to reconsider the sentence, citing the risks of lethality of COVID-19. The district attorney's office objected, saying the defendant was attempting to leverage COVID-19 to elude the consequences of his actions, later warning the judge Vecchiarelli was a high risk.
There were some serious public safety concerns about his release.
But the judge granted the release in part, citing COVID-19's impacts on the work release program. Weeks later, the assault allegedly occurred.
She sustained a fractured arm, bruising to her arms, legs, and her neck. She said that she'd been strangled.
Police and the Weld County Sheriff's Office are now searching for Vecchiarelli. The Sheriff's Office telling CBS4 they believe this all could have been prevented.
We're all worried about the release of inmates early, regardless of what the reason is. We should have been able to keep him at the jail to keep something like this from happening.
In Windsor, Dylan Thomas, covering Colorado First.
And we heard from the district attorney following our report, and he says that cases like this are, quote, a slap in the face to victims and the justice system.